Good morning, how you doing? My name is Kenneth Sykes and we're here at my home. And I'd like to tell you just a little bit about myself. I am a musician for 42, 43 years now. I currently work as a mental health worker at the office that handles a shelter for the homeless. My role there is to make sure that people come that are diagnosed with a mental illness, to make sure they're stable for shelter, meaning that they are not suicidal, homicidal, or unable to follow the staff directives due to their psychotic symptoms. I've been playing music since I was 6 years old. Some years ago, I worked for an outpatient therapy program, and I was the assistant to the music therapist for a while. And when the music therapist left, I had to do the music therapy. And I worked with people who were chronically ill. And so since that time, I says, you know, I wanted to continue to do this. So I volunteer again, you know, I volunteer and I go out. And helping these people have a greater experience at this age in their life. I love you. I mean, you can't help but have a relationship, some kind of relationship with them, other than just being, what's the word I'm looking for, on the surface, you know, because if you don't, you're just being mechanical. You understand what I'm saying? And so it is important really to establish something greater than just a rapport, but to, you know, become a little bit more intimate with them. Because they know whether you are or you're not.
Listen to your heart and what it's saying. Stop. Oh, look. Oh, listen to your heart.
There are a number of keys on the saxophone, and the interesting thing about the saxophone, with many wind instruments, there are combinations of a fingering that one has to do to get the notes. And so it can be somewhat complicated and it can be somewhat tricky, and the saxophone it takes a lot of energy to blow, and it takes a lot of patience to really learn. The biggest thing about it is knowing the instrument itself, because again, there are combinations of fingerings that have to take place in order to get certain notes. And there's something called the altissimo register, which is the highest place that a person can play on these instruments. And there's an artist, Gerald Albright, who's extremely good at that. And so the fingerings, are different than just playing down for a low C, you know. But again, one has to really study that and learn it in order to get a good quality sound, you know, in order to flow naturally. So I've been somewhat of a sheltered musician in my lifetime, meaning that the musical community of Philadelphia doesn't really know who I am, you know. People know me, you know, and I play out regularly and people hire me, but I'm somewhat of a musician who is not really well known in the musical community. But people have recognized me for some work that I've done with their organizations, but I can't even remember now. I don't even really keep up with stuff like that because I just really love to play. Of course, the change is fine, and it adds up and it helps. It helps that girl that's over there in college, with expenses. But the ultimate goal really is to move people with the music. Because you never know what people are going through. And I know it sounds kind of corny and cliches, but really, being true to the gift for me means that, I'm helping people get to a different place. You heard the guy the other day, he says, I was going through some things and listening to you put me in the mindset of driving down the highway, The sun is shining and the grass is on the side and whatnot with me, with my family, we're having a good time. Wow. That right there is unbelievable. There was a lady a few weeks ago, about 2 weeks ago, who, an older white woman, a gray-haired older white woman, and I played a song, it was a contemporary song, a John Legend. Not only did she know the song, but she says, you played so articulately, and you played in such a way where the notes were so sweet, and this and that and the third. And I says, wow, that's unbelievable. She hugged me and cried. I almost burst into tears after that, That's what it's all about. Well, stay true to your gift. Find out what your gifts are, people, and operate in your gifts. Because when you operate in what you're meant to do, that is in terms of what you do best, you will be most effective for yourself, first of all, and second of all, for the community. Love yourself.
Is I work in psychiatry, helping the homeless population. And so, I hope my boss will see that I spent some extra time out here. But anyway, it's great to be here. I really love helping out people. And so when this young man came and asked me to help with his project, I was more than happy to do so. I am Kenny Sykes, and we're gonna do a little bit more, but today that's it. And so look, I gotta get back to work. And so remember, bring the beat in! Love on top, y'all. All right.